Thank you. Eternal God, our Creator and Redeemer, as you gladden the wedding at Cana in Galilee by the presence of your Son, so by his presence now bring your joy to this wedding. Look in favor upon Sean and Karen, and grant that they, rejoicing in all your gifts, may at length celebrate with Christ the marriage feast, which has no end. Amen. You may be seated.
Beloved, let us love one another, because love is from God. Everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, for God is love. God's love was revealed among us in this way. God sent his only Son into the world so that we might live through him. In this is love, not that we love God, but that he loved us and sent his sons to be the atoning sacrifice for our sins. Beloved, since God loved us so much, we also ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God. If we love one another, God lives in us, and his love is perfected in us.
Grace be unto you and peace from God our Father and our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. In the beginning, God created this world through his sense of love. And it is through his love that we have been brought together to be united as husband and wife. When we come to this place, to God's house, we gather here with this company of witnesses and guests, we are sharing in God's love. We are saying to him that we are dedicating our lives to one another, and together we are dedicating our lives to God. So as you stand here this day, you express your love to each other, a love that is deep and abiding. You also express your love to God. And as the months and the years go by in your wedded relationship, you will be blessed by the love of God. Great things will happen to you. But also because we live in a world that is not perfect, all of us experience those things that are not so perfect. But it is God's love that binds us together, that helps us through the good times and the bad times. And the way that happens is by the two of you sharing with each other your love and your concern. From this day on, you no longer live for yourself. You live for each other, and you live for God. St. John's Church is overjoyed with the opportunity of sharing with you this day, officiating at this wedding and pronouncing you husband and wife. It is with the blessings of the people of this parish that we send you forth as husband and wife. So go now, love God, love one another, enjoy your lives together. The Lord God in his goodness created us male and female, and by the gift of marriage founded human community and a joy that begins now and is brought to perfection in the life to come. Because of sin, our age-old rebellion, the gladness of marriage can be overcast and the gift of the family can become a burden. But because God, who established marriage, continues still to bless it with his abundant and ever-present support, we can be sustained in our worthiness, have our joy restored. Sean, Karen, if it is your intention to share with each other your joys and sorrows and all that the years will bring, with your promises, bind yourselves to each other as husband and wife. I take you, Karen.
I take you, Karen.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise before God.
I promise before God.
And these witnesses.
And these witnesses.
To be your faithful husband.
To be your faithful husband.
To share with you in plenty.
Share with you in plenty.
And in want.
And in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To forgive and strengthen you.
To forgive and strengthen you.
And to join with you.
And join with you.
So that together.
So that together.
We may serve God.
We may serve God.
And others.
And others.
As long as we wish.
As long as we shall live.
I take you, Sean.
I take you, Sean.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise before God.
I promise before God.
And these witnesses.
And these witnesses.
To be your faithful wife.
To be your faithful wife.
To share with you in plenty.
To share with you in plenty.
And in want.
And in want.
And in joy and in sorrow.
And in joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To forgive and strengthen you.
To forgive and strengthen you.
And to join with you.
And to join with you.
So that together we may serve God.
So that together we may serve God.
And others.
And others.
As long as we both.
As long as we both.
Sean and Karen, by the promises before God and in the presence of this congregation, have bound themselves to one another as husband and wife. Blessed be the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. And those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Amen. The Lord God, who created our first parents and established them in marriage, establish and sustain you, that you may find life in each other and grow in holy love until your life's end. Amen.
Now we're back on solid ground, yeah.
Congregation, please stand. Let us bless God for all the gifts in which we rejoice today. Lord God, constant in mercy, great in faithfulness, with heart and love for the human family, for the heart of Israel, and for your people, the church. Aaron, have fun with each other. Such a sense of your constant love that we may employ all our strength in life. Aaron and Sean, that they may fulfill the vows they have made this day and reflect your steadfast love and their lifelong faithfulness to each other. As members with them of the body of Christ, use us to their life together, and from your great store of strength, give them power and patience, affection and understanding, courage and love toward you, toward each other, and toward the world, that they may continue together in mutual growth according to your will in Jesus Christ our Lord. Gracious Father, you bless the family and renew your people. Enrich husbands and wives, parents and children more and more with your grace, that strengthening and supporting each other, they may serve those in need and be a sign of the fulfillment of your perfect kingdom, where with your Son, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit, you live and reign, one God, through all ages of ages. Amen. Let us pray together our Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. May Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit,